Good morning.
Good morning.
And a blessed Easter to each of you. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
And because he lives, we too shall live both now and eternally, all because of our Savior. Would you do me a favor before we begin our service? Would you just stand up and turn around and say good morning? And blessed Easter, good morning to you. Good to see you, and God's peace be with each of you. Our service for today is projected on the screen. Feast of the Resurrection of our Lord. And our opening hymn is Jesus Christ is Risen Today. And we will rise in the last verse of the hymn we sing. May God bless our worship today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well-refined. This is the feast of victory for our God. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. This is the feast of victory for our God. He will swallow up death forever, And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. This is the feast of victory for our God. It will be said on that day, behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the feast of victory for our God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated as we sing our hymn. We continue with our confession and absolution. Forgive us, O Lord, when our sins entangle us and surround us. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Forgive us, Lord, when we seek earthly pleasures, but are negligent of things spiritual, when we are quick to gratify our bodies, but indifferent to receive your blessings. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Forgive us, Lord, when we are so eager to get, but so reluctant to give, so ready to receive your gifts, but so unwilling to bear the cross. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Forgive us, merciful Father, when we avoid making any commitment to you, when we doubt that you really see our sin, when we disobey your commandments, and are satisfied with only living for ourselves. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Forgive us, O Lord, when we are quick to find fault, but resentful when someone points out our faults, when we are so soon to play, but so late in prayer. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Father, forgive us when we rejoice in the temporary, but think little of the eternal. When we are so fond of being idle, but show little passion for helpful service, who will rescue me from this body of death? Who will rescue us from this body of death? Thanks be to God, he delivers us through Jesus Christ. By the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, I, a called and ordained servant of Christ, forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. We pray together in unison the collect of the day. Almighty God and Father, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, you've overcome death and opened the gate of everlasting life to us. Grant we who celebrate with joy the day of our Lord's resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. Please be seated as we sing our hymn, Now All the Vault of Heaven Resounds. Please be seated for our scripture readings. Our Old Testament reading for today for the resurrection of our Lord is from Exodus chapter 15, beginning with the first verse. And as always, our readings are projected on the screen for you to follow along if you desire. Then Moses and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord, saying, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. This is my God, and I will praise him, my father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is the name. Pharaoh's chariots and his host he cast into the sea, and his chosen officers were sunk in the Red Sea. The floods covered them. They went down into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, glorious in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy. In the greatness of your majesty, you overthrow your adversaries. You send out your fury. It consumes them like stubble. At the blast of your nostrils, the waters piled up. The floods stood up in a heap. The deeps congealed in the heart of the sea. The enemy said, I will pursue. I will overtake. I will divide the spoil. My desire shall have its fill of them. I will draw my sword. My hand shall destroy them. You blew with your wind. The sea covered them. They sank like lead in the mighty waters. Who is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, majestic in holiness, awesome in glorious deeds, doing wonders? This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our psalm of the day is from Psalm 16. I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure, because you will not abandon me to the grave, nor will you let your Holy One see decay. You have made known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. We sing our hymn, Good Christian Friends, Rejoice and Sing, 475. Our epistle reading is from 1 Corinthians 15, which is the resurrection chapter of the Bible and of 1 Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers, of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, in which you stand, and by which you are being saved. If you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain, for I have delivered to you of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unworthy to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we preach, and so you believed. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. As you're able, we rise at this time for our holy gospel. The holy gospel and also our text for today's message is according to St. Mark, the 16th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb, and they were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe, and they were alarmed. And he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We sing together our creedal hymn. Be seated. Once again, good morning. Good to be with you in God's house on this blessed day, and for you who are at home or wherever you are, we pray the Lord's richest blessings. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And that's our hope now and eternally in Jesus, our risen Lord, yours and mine and the world's. Would you do me a favor? Unless you are listening to this broadcast, don't do this, but the rest of you, I ask you to do this. Would you close your eyes for a moment? Just keep them closed. What do you see? Darkness? Nothing? Empty? Would you open them again? Would you go to the next slide for me? That's what the women and the disciples felt when they saw their Savior, their Lord, whom they followed when he died on the cross. Everything seemed empty, dark, and it seemed as if there was no hope. But then when the women came to the tomb that morning and they looked in, would you go to the next one? Everything changed. Everything changed. Light and hope and peace and life and meaning and purpose came back to them. For the angel told them, he's not here. He's risen just as he told you, and he did. And because that he means, it means for us that we have forgiveness for all of our sins. We have hope for today and tomorrow. We have a future. We have purpose. In our tomb will too be empty at the coming of Jesus. A resurrection awaits us through Jesus Christ. And that means everything. I'm going to leave this slide on. Would you do me a favor again? Would you close your eyes, please, except for if you're driving? You can't see Jesus or the picture of him. Is it still there? Absolutely. Open them again. And so that is for us. In times when things seem dark or it seems troubling or trials or whatever it may be, Jesus, though you may not see him with your eyes, he's there always. And he promises to uplift, to strengthen, and he promises to see us through and bring us home. Now that's an awesome message to know, but it's just as awesome a message that we need to share with the world. In the name of Jesus, our risen Lord, amen. Please pray with me. Gracious Lord, we thank you and praise you. We thank you that you came down into the darkness of this world and our lives and sin and death, and you brought life and light. We thank you that you not only overcame the grave, but you overcame sin and Satan and all enemies. And you've set us free that we might now live for you, live eternally because of you. We know that you're with us always, O Lord, in the good and bad. And we know that we have hope in you. Keep us firm in that faith and hope. Amen. We sing our hymn. Our hymn is He's Risen, 480.
Thank you.
God's grace and peace be multiplied unto each of you this day from God our Father and from our risen Savior Jesus. Amen. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Our text for today's message was the gospel reading read a few moments ago. You may be seated. Please join with me in a word of prayer. We pray. Gracious Lord, praise you and thank you this day as we come and we remember, Jesus, your victory. We remember that you conquered sin and death in the grave, not only by your cross, but by your empty tomb. Keep that hope firm in our hearts, and may we ever be empowered to declare and share that good news with the world. I pray now that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart may ever be pleasing and acceptable in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. In Jesus, our Savior's name, we pray. Amen. Beloved in the Lord Jesus Christ, first of all, how good it is to be with you who are here and, of course, wherever you are on this blessed day. I remember what last year was like. Perhaps you remember it too. It was very weird to be preaching on Easter morning and just seeing a handful of people, and how good it is to be with you in God's house. But even on this day, we come with questions in our hearts, don't we? Even with the vaccine out, many of us have questions when things are going to get back to the norm, or at least as normal as we'd like them to be. We have questions about the economy and how things will go with that. We have questions about, well, the unrest and the violence that we see in the world, in this life. And we have just the daily grind and the daily things that bring us down. And we question and we wonder, what will the future bring? You know what? If that's how you feel this day, we're very much like the women who were going to the tomb that morning early when they got up. They had questions too. And the one was, who will roll the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb? Good question, wasn't it? Would you go on to the next one? I have a photo of this is what a tomb looks like in the Holy Land. And perhaps this was one that looked very similar to the one that Jesus was placed in. Notice it's squarish opening and you have to kind of duck your head to get in. And notice to the left, there's a stone, that big round one there. It's a larger one, isn't it? What they do is when they put the body in the tomb, then they'll have, it just isn't one person, you have a couple of strong people and they push that stone and it actually slides down in, and notice there's stone on the other side that stops it in front of it so it won't fall, so it will stay there. Keep it from tipping over. The tomb, you see, could have been similar to that which Jesus looked like. He's placed in his body. When Joseph of Arimathea put Jesus' body in the tomb, no doubt with some help, they would have pushed that stone down, and the stone would have come down with a stop, with a loud thud. Mark tells us it was a very large stone. And when it came to a rest, it wasn't going anywhere, at least it would have seemed. And one could only imagine what it would be like. We're seeing it from the outside, what it would have been like in the inside. Nothing but darkness and silence. It all appeared to be finished and done. It would appear that it would have been all over and done with. The disciples had run for their lives. They deserted the Lord. Joseph and Nicodemus risked everything to bury Jesus. With a large stone in front of the tomb. But very early in the morning, the women come to the tomb. And all that changes. The women come to the tomb, have all they need to carry for the body of Jesus. Yet they forgot that one small detail. Well, a pretty large detail, wasn't it? Who will roll away the stone and let them in? However, when we get to the tomb, they find that it's all taken care of. The stone has already been pushed away. The tomb is open. The women are amazed, and at the same time, they're fearful. They enter the tomb, and they're met by an angel with a message. He's risen. He's not here. He's alive, and he's going to meet his disciples just as he said he would. And that message was huge. That message changed everything for them and for us in our world. Jesus' resurrection from the dead is larger than any large stone or anything else. The women go in to anoint the body, but instead they hear a message that will change their lives forever. And so for us too, theirs and ours, because our Lord lives. And that changes everything, because we have a living God and a living Savior. That separates the Christian faith from any other religion. We have a living and victorious Lord. You know, Jesus told them so on several occasions. Jesus had told the disciples that they were going to Jerusalem, that he'd be arrested, that he'd be on trial, that he would be convicted and killed. But on the third day, he would rise from the dead. Now, the angel asked the women at the tomb to carry that message of "I told you so" back to the disciples, just as he told you and me in his word. It shows that Jesus is always, he tells the truth, always. In fact, he is the way, the only way to the Father, to heaven. He is the truth, the only truth, after all. And even in all of his promises, even the ones that seem so incredible, Jesus is to be believed, because he tells the truth. He is risen, just as he told you. It happened on the third day, as foretold, just as it said. He would meet with them in Galilee, and he did, just as he told them. In fact, everything that Jesus told the disciples and tells us are true. He told them, and he told us so. But they doubted. And they disbelieved. To various degrees, the disciples had a hard time believing the truth, what Jesus said. Judas, sadly, tragically, lost his faith. He walked away. Peter denied Jesus temporarily. Thomas doubted it. He had to touch the wounds and see the risen Lord to believe. Then he confessed the faith. The women came that morning expecting to find a dead body. None of them believed perfectly and fully, and neither do we. But thanks be to God, Jesus died for such sinners as them and us, didn't he? And he rose to give evidence that he can be trusted, that his word is sure. His disciples would come to believe what he told them. And by the Spirit's power, we believe too, either hearing the word or through the holy waters of holy baptism, that Christ not only died, but he rose victorious, just as he said. So what does that tell us, and what does that mean today as we come? As we go forward in the days to come. Well, what he said about his resurrection came true, just as he said, then it only follows that other things he said is true too. Romans 8 is one of my favorite portions of Scripture. Not only does it tell us that nothing now shall separate us from the love of God, but it also said, He, being the Heavenly Father, He who did not spare His own Son, but gave Him up for us all, how will He not also, along with Him, graciously give us all things? All things that we need for this life and for the life to come, all because of Jesus. If His greatest promise proved right, it did, then we can know that all other things are true as well. So what does that say? What does Jesus say through it? For it too must be true. Let's avoid the "I told you so." Well, He says a lot, doesn't He, in God's Word? More than I can even cover in this sermon. He had 3 years of public ministry, 3.5, preaching and teaching, much of which were written down, and we have it in His Word that points to Him and the salvation He brings. He said a lot, didn't He? So we have to put in a little bit of a summary. Well, Jesus summarized the law in this way. He said, the most important law is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. And the second is like it, to love your neighbor as yourself. Love God and love neighbor. And love is a summary of the law, isn't it? That's what Jesus proclaimed. And in this, we fail too, don't we? All of us, including myself. We fail miserably. We fail often. We fail accidentally, and we fail willfully. We don't love enough, and we're not good enough. But far more than showing us our sin, Jesus shows us the way out. He shows us hope. He shows us where deliverance comes. He gives us Himself. He brings good news. In fact, He is good news. He's the greatest news of all. And this is our faith. That He died for us in our place on the cross to pay for our sin and the sin of the world. And that He rose for us. And that He promises, the promises He made are true. And that the promises still out there that are to come will be fulfilled because of Him. Let's go to the next one. Of course, isn't that how it goes? I thought I put another slide in there. Ah, that's the one. Without Jesus, that's what it would have been like. Go to the next one. But with Jesus, it changes everything. With His open tomb, it points to our open tombs too, graves. For we too shall rise from the grave because of Him. Go on to the next one, please. All because of Him and what He's done. For we too shall rise on the last day, not only when we die, our soul through faith in Jesus, for all who believe in Him will be with the Lord and will have nothing to fear. When we close our eyes to this life, we shall see our Lord. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. He will see us through, just as that picture says, of the Good Shepherd through the valley. It leads to life eternal for us and for our loved ones in Christ. And it means, in fact, those our loved ones who died in the faith are already with the Lord and awaiting us. And I don't know about you, but I look forward to the day of seeing our loved ones again in Christ. But you know what? Even more, I look forward to seeing Jesus our risen Lord. But we have more to look forward to. It will not only be our spirit with the Lord, the fullest and the final and the completion of the promises happens, will happen, when we rise on the last day. And we'll live forever, incorruptible body, imperishable body, with Jesus our Lord. That's the hope of Easter. The promise of Christ, then too it will be just as he told you. So that means Jesus isn't the only one with something to tell. We too have a message to share in a world that needs to hear the message of Christ. Not only were the women told to go and tell, and the men would be charged to do that too, so are we, every single person who is a child of God through faith in Jesus, are to go and tell. And I don't mean some corny message or a platitude, but a natural, honest sharing of the hope that is within us to the world whenever opportunity comes. We have good news. In fact, we have the greatest news of all in our risen Lord. We can tell who Jesus is and what he's done and how he is always, his truth is always true, just as he told us. We can tell by the kindness in which we share to those who are around us. We can tell by the comforting word when the opportunity arises. We can go and tell as we are able and also invite others to come and see. But to go and tell also means we need to continue to come and see, whether that's in person or wherever we are or at home reading our Bible. Open it, for God speaks to you, and his word is a word of promises and hope for us in the world. Here we find truth in a world of lies. Here is someone, something reliable in this world of unreliable people. Here in his Holy Supper, we touch his presence, his body and blood, and take it in for the forgiveness of sins in with and under the bread and wine. Here in his presence, according to his promise. Here in the message of Jesus, is the only real lasting hope for you and for this world. For those struggling through a life of sorrow and difficulty, here is his presence according to his promise. And here in the message of Jesus is the only real and lasting hope that is greater than any stone or any trouble or trial. Just as he told you. Mary and the women went and they told what they had heard and seen. And we do the same. May we, by his power, forgiveness and life now and eternal is ours in Jesus. Yes, Jesus' resurrection is larger than any stone or anything else. For Christ is risen. He's risen indeed. And we shall live eternally. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed.
Alleluia.
Alleluia means praise the Lord. May we praise him eternally. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all human understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the true faith unto life everlasting through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We continue at this time by singing the Day of Resurrection.
Amen.
We sing our offertory verse as the offering is brought forward at this time. Our prayers for this morning, the majority of them are projected on the screen for you today. We pray. Gracious God, you know how often fear grabs hold and at times suffocates us. Being so overwhelmed with the future, we choose to live in the past, paralyzed with fear and dread. Send forth your Holy Spirit as we celebrate our Savior's victory over everything, everything that enslaves us and holds us captive. Let his living presence cheer us when we are in sorrow. Strengthen us when we're in trial. Revive us when we lose hope. Cheer us when we feel hopeless. And kindle in us an undying devotion to the truth of his shed blood, his empty tomb, and his promise of life everlasting. For with our whole hearts we say, Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. Blessed are those who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Loving Lord, keep us walking steadfastly toward our heavenly home, that paradise that is our true inheritance. Support us through every sorrow, and even if others think our Easter faith folly, let us trust in you all the days of our lives, even as we say, Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. Blessed are those who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Standing underneath our Savior's cross, where healing streams descend, and where we are washed in his all-cleansed blood, Father, we acknowledge that every enemy was defeated at Calvary. Envy, strife, and hatred lost the battle. So did Satan, our accuser, and death, our last enemy. In the empty tomb, this victory is ours forever. And though at times the triumph song is heard only faintly in the distance, we thank you because our Savior will completely restore us when he comes again. And so we say, Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. Blessed are those who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Heavenly Father, thank you that in worship our minds are transformed, our spirits are made whole, our hope is restored, and we become shining lights filled with our Savior's love, so that we can say to the world, Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. Blessed are those who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. In Jesus' name, amen. We further pray, O Lord. We pray for comfort for those who mourn the loss of loved ones. We especially remember the family of Pastor James Hendrickson, who was called to his heavenly home through faith in Jesus, and all who mourn. Comfort all who mourn with this truth, that they may not grieve as others who do not have hope, but be assured of reunion and of resurrection in Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord, grant your blessing and your healing care and strength to those who are in need of your healing hand and blessing and care. Especially remember Paul Pelkey, Alan Clark, Dave Dietz, Sandy and Ken Rosensky, Gil Schultz, Carl Cook, Carol Schultz, Larry Novak, Ivlis Rawling, Vicky Gierke, Roger Hansen, Emily Rogers, Margaret Kruger, along with those who've been affected by the virus and all those who care for them, that they may know the fullness of your love, your presence, and your salvation, even in the midst of their trials. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Holy Spirit, continue to guide us in finding an early childhood teacher at our St. Peter's School. Lead us to know whom you desire to serve and lead them to come and teach in our school. We pray for your will to be done. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All these things and whatever else you know that we need, grant us, Father, for the sake of him who died and rose again, and now lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we sing the first four verses of our hymn, I Know That My Redeemer Lives. Before I give the benediction, I thought I would announce, I was asked to announce about the, for Pastor Hendrickson for his funeral. It will be on Wednesday at 11 a.m. in Janesville at St. Paul's Lutheran Church, the visitation from 4 to 7 on Tuesday at Schneider Funeral Home in Janesville. Thanks be to God because he lives. We too shall live, and he does too because of our Lord. Would you rise for our benediction and for our closing hymn? Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. The Lord bless you and keep you. Lord, make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and grant you his peace. Amen. Remain standing for the last verses of our hymn.
Thank you.
Please be seated. A very blessed Easter to each of you. There are some refreshments as you go out today. The Lord bless your day and your week ahead.